And I know we have a few. Welcome to the University of Auckland's graduation ceremonies. This is our fourth ceremony today, and this one is for the Faculty of Business and Economics. Your students or graduands will be coming in very soon, and do feel free to take photographs of them, but please be considerate of the people around you who might also be wanting to take photographs. After the students process in, they'll be followed by our academics and then the official party. Please remain standing during this time and do feel free to join in the singing of Gaudiamus. Now is a really good time for you to switch off your mobile phone, please. At the end of the ceremony, we will all sing the national anthem together with your graduates. When the official party leaves, the graduates will follow. Please wait until all the graduates have left this auditorium before then following them out. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for your graduands.
Thank you. tirama hara mai ra piki mai ra whakatau mai ra tēnei te karanga aroha te karanga mahana te karanga mai oha mai te whare wānanga o tā maki makaurau kia koutou kua eke mai nei i te pōnei e kia koutou ngā tauira kua eke mai rā ki tā koutou pōtaitanga tēnā koutou tēnā koutou tēnā tātou katoa.
Please be seated. Inga mana, inga reo, inga ho e wha. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou koutou. Vice-Chancellor, Pro-Chancellor, Council members, special guests, staff, graduands, family and friends of graduands. As Chancellor of the University of Auckland, I extend a warm welcome to you all on behalf of University Council members and staff of the University. In particular, I welcome our guest speaker, Mr. Fadi Mashriki. This is a meeting of the Council of the University of Auckland for the purpose of conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. This week, we will be conferring and awarding more than 7,000 qualifications on some 6,400 students in person and in absentia. At this ceremony, 483 students will graduate in person and 118 students will graduate in absentia. I will be assisted by Mr. Peter Kiley, Pro-Chancellor, in awarding diplomas and conferring degrees today. This is a happy and memorable occasion for you, the graduands, as well as your family and friends who have supported you during your studies. We congratulate you all. Equally, your achievement brings pleasure and satisfaction to the academic and professional staff of the university who have played their part in your success. The graduation procession today brought academic flavour and colour to the streets of Auckland, and in this ceremony, you'll experience the pomp and tradition befitting your well-deserved day of celebration. Over a period of 130 years, the University of Auckland has become a comprehensive, research-led university with a strong international reputation. Today, there are more than 40,000 students and 5,000 staff. Moreover, we are New Zealand's largest research organisation with one-third of the country's externally rated world-class academic researchers. Within New Zealand, only our university is ranked within the top 1% of the world's universities. We have a strong commitment to Maori and Pacific education. Of all the Maori degree graduates in New Zealand each year, 25% come from just one institution, the University of Auckland. The figure for Pacific graduates is 40%. We jealously guard our position amongst our competitor universities and are always looking to create new opportunities for all our undergraduate and postgraduate students. Last month, we confirmed the purchase of the 5.2-hectare former Lion Breweries site on Kuiper Pass. This purchase will provide the university with a site for expansion over the next 50 years. It is contiguous with the City and Grafton campuses and with a major business area in Newmarket. who will occupy the first of the new facilities in November 2014. So as you graduate, please reflect on ongoing learning opportunities and consider the wide range of postgraduate options available to you at Auckland. I ask you to consider that because we can never rest on our laurels, especially in a challenging and ever-changing world. Whatever path you follow, I urge you, as the alumni of New Zealand's leading university, to never forget your alma mater. We rely on our graduates for support, moral, political, and financial. Funding constraints are a perennial problem for New Zealand universities, who are being asked to do more and more with less and less each year. In fact, in these hard times, we should be spending more on universities, not less. But that is enough of the substantial issues facing us all as members of a 21st century university with high aspirations. Today is your day, with the focus firmly on your achievement. At this ceremony, we honour your success, along with the support of your family, whānau, and others who have sustained you through your studies. I congratulate you and trust that you will long cherish the memories of your graduation today. I am delighted to welcome as our guest speaker Fadi Mashriqi, an alumnus of the University of Auckland and the chief executive of Power by Proxy, which he co-founded. Fadi has a bachelor's degree in engineering and commerce. By the time he'd completed his project on wireless electricity for his engineering degree, Fadi knew he was onto something. Wireless electricity using electromagnetic induction was not new, but he saw a way to make it feasible for an array of electronic devices to deliver unplugged power. The result was Power by Proxy, which he founded in 2007. Fadi was involved with both Spark, the university entrepreneurship competition, and later the Ice House. During his company's gestation, he secured the company's first major break with John Deere, the world's largest maker of farm and forestry equipment based in the USA. He has since led Power by Proxy to acquire a further 30 customers, with six of these being Fortune 100 companies. While the company has global reach, with all of its customers located outside New Zealand, Fadi firmly believes that Auckland is the home of wireless power. He is passionate about New Zealand entrepreneurship and continues to take an active interest in nurturing New Zealand talent. Please welcome with me to the stage, Fadi Mashriqi.
Chancellor, Vice Chancellor, members of Council, members of the University, graduands, families, and friends, it is truly my honour to address you today as a very proud alumnus of this fine university. I'd like to start by congratulating all of you graduands. You will leave today with an outstanding education from an outstanding university, one that I can personally attest to, both in my career and in the many fine graduates we hire into our company from this university. I remember sitting where you are today, 8 years ago, trying to work out what I should do next. Today, I thought I would firstly share what happened after I walked out of those doors, and secondly, leave you with a big challenge. After graduating, I decided to found my company. I had two unsuccessful starts, but in 2007, almost 3 years after I graduated, Power by Proxy was born. It was a time when many friends and peers had decided to go on OEs or take jobs overseas, and it would have been very easy to just give up and do the same. but I genuinely felt I could build something of global significance from New Zealand. And I decided to stay behind and do exactly that. One of my favorite quotes by George Bernard Shaw reads, "The reasonable man adapts himself to the world. The unreasonable man persists in trying to adapt the world to himself. Therefore, all progress depends on the unreasonable man." So, recently I was transiting in London when an article on rugby in the Evening Standard caught my attention. Specifically, a paragraph that said, "In nearly all else apart from rugby, New Zealand as a nation is a model of humility and reasonableness. The opposite is true when it comes to rugby. They expect to win, demand to win, and when they don't, it is as if not just the players wearing the fabled black shirt, but the whole nation has failed." I started to imagine what New Zealand would be like if every single one of you graduating today applied that attitude to win, to endeavors that create prosperity, that ultimately enable us to build the best schools, the best universities, hospitals, roads, stadiums, and so on and so forth, and be the envy of the world. What would our country look like then? So sitting where you are today, I decided to start my career living on $10,000 a year, selling everything I owned on Trade Me to bootstrap a business with absolutely no guaranteed chance of success. Why on earth would you want to do that? Some would call it madness. My mum is a doctor and she certainly did. I prefer the term unreasonableness, but they could be the same thing. As a kid, I also managed to electrocute myself three times, experimenting with mains power. So it's not surprising that I now want to unwire the world. We were born, taught, and nurtured in the Spark Business Planning Competition, which is a really fantastic initiative of this faculty. I was also supported by many other parts of the rapidly developing entrepreneurial ecosystem. Too many parts to mention here today. Movac, who was famous for their early investment in TradeMe, provided the capital to fund our global expansion plans and set up our first office in the USA. More recently, we closed a $5 million US dollar strategic investment from TE Connectivity, a New York Stock Exchange listed company with a market capitalization of over $20 billion US dollars. We now employ over 50 people and have offices in Auckland, in Silicon Valley, and also in Atlanta. In the process, we have also funded many internships and many scholarships at this university. We've done that since day one, since 14th of August 2007, even as the company was not profitable. Our customers today view us as the global leader in our space, and they include some of the largest companies in the world, including many significant names from Japan, Korea, Europe, as well as the USA. Many are in the Fortune 100 and Fortune 500. It can be done from New Zealand. When I look out across this hall, I see the future of this country and the businesses that will make it prosper. So, my challenge to you graduating today is to think about how you can take advantage of the world-class entrepreneurial ecosystem we have in New Zealand. Think about how you can create great businesses here and bring prosperity to New Zealand, yourself, and others who may choose to join you. To those retiring in the next decade or two, maybe some of your teachers, some of the parents in the room, those who have supported these young graduates, I also have a challenge for you. Think about how you can support and invest in a young graduate. I certainly would not be here today speaking to you had I not had people invest and support me. I'd especially recommend you do this if you want to enjoy a fully funded retirement. You'll know we've succeeded and the nation's future is secure when the next generations dream of building big global businesses from New Zealand. Businesses in which they expect and demand to win on the global stage. Graduates, you have a world-class education, a brilliant foundation to build on, and to become this nation's next unreasonable men and women in anything you choose to do. Let us all hope that New Zealand's next Fonterra scale business is created by one of you sitting in this room. Congratulations to you all once again, and thank you.
Freddie, what a most inspiring and challenging address. I think we could do with more people like you throwing the gauntlet down in front of us. Can I ask you all to join with me in thanking Freddie once more? This is a meeting of Council and Convocation of the University at which the Pro-Chancellor Peter Kiley and I will be conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I invite the Pro-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of the ceremony.
By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Peter Kiley, Pro-Chancellor, confer the degrees and award the diplomas stated upon those who, within the faculty, have satisfied the requirements of this university.
I call upon an Associate Dean of the Faculty of Business and Economics, Mrs. Lawrenson, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Associate Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Business and Economics. To the degree of Bachelor of Business and Information Management, Sarah Akbar Nimani. Patricia Priscilla Rani Chand. Emma Manlin Chen. Ian Robert Clapworthy. Alisi Thiri Solavanua. Ryan Ford. Ashley Roger Gleason. Larissa Kate Hastings. Alice Elizabeth Johnson. Revati Karandika. Bhumika Kaushal. Kushi Joginda Khanna. Drew Courtney Laidlaw. Siuwola Evangelia Latu. Jin Lee. Nico Andrew Lumangtar. Donald Rain Mason. Michael James Mather. Muntan Hamantbhai Mehta. Carmen Wee. Sharmina Maya Patel. Chin Ji Ki. Ayesh Rajura. Darshan Shivji Ramji. Reza Saeed. Shavindra Deo Sharma. Kushbu Solanki. Ryan Douglas Stamp. Taulia Tafiti. Nicholas Kiong Hung Tiang. Andrew Stephen Underwood. Brandon Patrick Wallace. Sean Arm Wong. Kong Wei. Wen Ying. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Anthony Graham Williams. Ting Yang. Ilya Valerimovich Zarinkov. Janet Shenzhu. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce, Hu Chan Kung. Mridul Kapoor. Tingaraj Kaur. Scott Kennedy. Safia Ahmad Khan. Bhavik Khatri. Jeffrey Bu Jin Ku. Yon Hee Kim. Hyun Seok Kim. Min Jung Kim. Yeji Kim. Young Ki Kim. Clinton Graham King. James Anito Kippenberger. Sarah Alice Knight. Thomas Cox. Rin Khan. Andrea Michelle Copus. Chantal Natasha Court. Nathan Lee Hongkot. Alicia Kruglik. Alexandros Murray Dimitri Kouimandian. Dhruv Kumar. Kunal Kumar, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Shannon Sheenal Rani Kumar. Chihin Kwok. Boyd Po Ching Lai. Karen Ka Woon Lai. Siv Him Lang. Alpesh Lala. Angela Sarah Larkin. Yi Wen Lau. Charles Lover Mao. Thomas Richard Campbell Lawson. Anna Lee. Chi-Wen Lee. Cynthia Senart Lee. Ellen Lee Shirky. Hong Jun Lee. Jay Hong Lee. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Lee Jian Ren. Jonathan Michael Lee. Kyung Tek Lee. Ming Zit Lee. Yi Sen Lee. Daniel Morgan Lewis. Feng Fei Lee. Ping Lee. Wei Cheng Liang. Eric Ao Nan Liang. Chu Nan Liang. David Che Seong Lim. Jai Jun Lim. William Bernhard Lim. Runs Lin. Erin Elizabeth Lovell. Emma Catherine Lowry. Thomas Garth Lundon, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Hing Wei Lu. Zhao Lu. Vinay Mahant. Paran Makan. Ritika Kishore Mangharmalani. Jason Abram Marilik. Trent William Maris. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Monique Olivia Matic. Iliganoa Rani Melissa Matu. Hayden David McGregor and a graduate diploma in commerce. James Kenneth McKenzie. Bryony Grace Medhurst. Andre Medich. Corbin Peter Meehan. Peruna Maya Milovanovic. Paul Robert Towers Minus. Namrata Modak. Deepika Mohan Kumar. Casey Renee Morris. Sabia Mughal. Jonathan Rex Muliaga. Fatih Amza Muzaffar. Shino Naika. Anastasia Nalmova. Petra Manalika Kiriana Nas. Jacqueline Ng Chin Ru. Stephanie Yayi Nong and a graduate diploma in commerce. Hien Tu Ti Nian. Faisley Nissa. Jeffrey Thomas Novak. Christopher Frank Nunes. Michael Patrick O'Flaherty. James Oliver Roche. Melissa May Leong. Christopher William Osborne. Nicholas George Richard Osborne. Amrita Kaur Pagaman Singh. Linda Miran Park. Sojin Park. Rupin Lalu Patel. Sanit Patel and a graduate diploma in commerce. Shraddha Janhavi Patel. Urvashi Patel and a graduate diploma in commerce. Betsy Meron Paul. Ma Andrea De Vera Pena. Lekamaj Uvini Mantila Pereira. Kia Liang Pan. Viham Hall and a graduate diploma in commerce. Yin Jing Piao. Achal Prakash. Shavnil Ranjan Prasad. Yogesh Prasad. Yi Cheng Chin. Andrew John Quirk. Yusra Rogid. Navisha Indra Rai. Joel Timothy Ramdhari. Anusha Vasanti Raniga. Rushikesh Shantanal Raniga. Michelle Allison Rapson. Kamani Karishma Reddy. Felicity Adrian Bovid Reed and a graduate diploma in commerce. Gideon Retief. Hannah Victoria Richardson. Alexander Thomas Rippon. Joshua Neil Robinson. Bruna Carolina Rodriguez. Rodney Britt Gerald Rodriguez. Adam Dominic Rowland. Lucy Zijing Rong. Cherry Amy Rosa. Joshua Weston Rosa. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Stuart James Riddell. Christopher Dean Lockett Rusko. Changhun Ryong. Yu Su Ryu. Su Wu Ryu. Adeline Joy Escoto Saavedra. Master Preda Saying D. Homara Sagha. Kaisa Maria Sahi. Yatin Saluja. Michael John Sanders. Brett Christopher Sargon. Emma Louise Scowcroft. Huan Nicholas Segura Triana. Jingling Shangguang. Akash Chandra Sharma and a graduate diploma in commerce. Ashwin Shelvin Sharma and a graduate diploma in commerce. Jocelyn Shenji Ting. Zane Rex Cherry. Deanna Mary Shaw. Jonathan David Shortall. David Anthony Shorter. Alisa Catherine Tremaine. Aman Sanjay Singh. Rajneet Prakash Singh. Kumilaine Sisson. Leah Snelson. Yuzo Su. Mia Song. Ming Da Song. Ji Ching Song. Kamal Nikhil Suisa. Susan Margaret Stenner. Aaron John Stewart. Dean Adrian Stone. Ji Yang Su. Nikki Suen. Inwoo Su. Andrei Sukhomlinov. Xu Song. Adam Warwick Sykes. Jason Henry Simons and a graduate diploma in commerce. Olga Taborina. Audrey Ya Tin Tan. Joshua Benjamin Tan. Moon Ching Tan.
Thank you, Pro-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding the diplomas in the first half of this ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performances by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Shauna Isamura, accompanied by Kento Isamura, will now perform Zigguna Weissen, Opus 20, by Pablo de Sarasate. Shauno, that was simply stunning. Can I ask you all to join with me in showing our appreciation? By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Business and Economics, have satisfied the requirements of this university. I now call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Business and Economics, Professor Whitred, to present further graduands in the faculty.
To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce, Sean Tan Jing Yi. Sean Tan Si Yung. Sin Yin Tan. Tian Yao Tan. Tan Jen Xiang, Ji Kai Tan, Hoi Ling Tan, Matthew Carl Taylor. Michael Robert Taylor and a graduate diploma in commerce. Joanne Kai Lian T. Campbell Finn Thompson. Michelle Chen Thompson and a graduate diploma in commerce. Rebecca Thornburg. Yuan Yuan Tian. Nicholas John Tonkin. Somia Totha and a graduate diploma in commerce. Nika Toussaint. Susan Tov and a graduate diploma in commerce. Kyle Keith Tucker. Kalissi Bakley Matiasi Tuilomo. Jessica Kate Tweed. Brandon Allen Twigley. Dennis Tyurkov, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Tua Lili Tom Vaiavai. Roynil Kumar Valab. Zainay Van Golden. Virawit Vasi Thamrong. Avoaya Vole. Benjamin Sakala Wallace. Ka Long Wan. Bo Wong. Dan Dan Wong. Kelly Chu Lee Wong. Yi Xuan Wong. Wong Ji Xian. Oshan Jayamal Waniarachi. Lauren Marie Warner. Cameron Joseph Watton. Richard Thornton Wild. Catherine Ashley Willisy. Ayla Louise Wilson. Joshua Howard Wilson. Olivia Louise Wilson. Matthew Paul Winnard. Bonnie C. Ching Wong. Jan Lam Wong. Justin Brian Wong. James David Wood. Philippa Jane Wright. Adele Kathleen Wright St. Clair, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Wanling Wu. Xingxian Wu. Nicholas Gary Bruce Wikes. Wenrui Shi. Lin Xuan Xu. Man Qing Yang. Anna Yu. Hai Qing Yan Yin. Jong Min Yun. Tae Yon Yun, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Ji Won Yuan. Catherine Louise Young. Hang Yu. Ji Lin Yue. Jingya Zhang. Lei Zhang. Li Fan Zhang. Lu Zhang. Teng Zhang. Yi Zhang. Ying Zhang. Zixia Zhang. Li Hong Zheng. Tianyi Zhou. Bing Kun Ju. Hui Yi Ju. Ya Mei Ju. Ting Ting Zhou. Zufahana Zerkanain. To the degree of Bachelor of Property Conjoint, Ahmad Asker, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Olivia Sharon Burt, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Priyesh Rahinda Dana, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Joshua Keith Emmett, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Jason Joseph Ho, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Zane Grant Irwin, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Matthew David Lee, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Kevin Liu, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Siren Martin McIlvaina, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Michael Terence O'Connell, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Trent Patrick O'Keefe, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Joel David Porras, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Aslyn Else Jean Rogers, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Alice Georgina Kirsty Ross, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Joanna Renee Angelis Villaflor, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Bailey Jean Field Ward, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Andrew James Weepers, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Alistair James Young, and a Bachelor of Arts. To the degree of Bachelor of Property, Hannah Dawn Cleary. Adam David Curtis. Ethan James Denton. Simon Peter Finlay. Cheng Chu Han. Jennifer Lee Hayes. Hugo Khan. Andrew James Matheson. Jean Daniel Merkel. Henry Philip Morris. Petar Perkovic. Brent Carl Schmidt. Minnie So. Adam Morgan Taylor. Ian Blake West. Brian James Wiggle. Nicholas Hugh Wilkinson. Greta Arlov Williamson. Yawen Wu. Postgraduate Diploma in Business. Oladipo Adebola Ajayi in Administration. Punet Bannott in Administration. Christopher Morgan Brown in Administration. Anthony Douglas Arapita Burt in Administration. Gabrielle Ann Cleasy in Administration. Shane Robert Frederick Coots in Administration. Jason Robert Cox in Administration. Lei Sui in Administration. Shanika Maheshi Downward in Administration. Heather Jean Ellis in Human Resource Management. Farzana Haq in Human Resource Management. Kerry Wayne Hurst in Operations Management. Jenna Kai Chin Su in Health Management. Philip Isa Johnston in Administration. Randeep Singh Kakar in Administration. Drew Kennedy in Administration. Fiona Barbara Kingsford in Administration. Paras Kumar in Administration. Sanjay Kumar in Administration. Hua Lin in Administration. Wendy Mary Mainwaring in Administration. Troy Ross Manning in Administration. James Hugh McKenzie McIntosh in Human Resource Management. Vuk Malonsik, Administration. Marty Magdalena Mola in Human Resource Management. Louise Elizabeth Mullane in Administration. Roham Ramachandran Nair in Administration. Zvenika Gerald Doro in Administration. Carlos Eduardo Penha in Administration. Glenn Dwayne Sayer in Administration. Wai Yong Seat in Administration. Sarah Selwood in Human Resource Management. Amit Yorty Sen in Administration. Richard Bryan William Seymour Wright in Administration. John Norman Sharp in Administration. Heliana Saltes in Administration. Pablo Federico Vignola in Administration. Jeffrey Allen Waite in Administration. Carl Roger Wallace in Administration. Kathleen Doris Walsh in Administration. Catherine Sophia Webster, Administration. Catherine Nancy Grace Welch in Administration. Kelly Michelle Wilson, Human Resource Management. Colette Owen Wood in Human Resource Management. Ying Wu in Administration. Postgraduate Diploma in Property, Mingyue Liu. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with First Class Honours, Nikitha Akalanka Kariyo Wawasam in Finance. Rajwant Kaur in Marketing and a Bachelor of Commerce. Alexander Charles Kirch in Finance and a Bachelor of Commerce. Katerina Anatolievna Koppel in Finance and a Bachelor of Commerce. Shiva Krishan in Marketing. Buyan Kritalika in Economics. Su Jen Lo in Accounting. University Graduate Scholar Katerina Hui Jing Lu in Accounting. Nicholas Ryan Ma in Finance and a Bachelor of Commerce. Xin Yi Ng in Accounting. Elena Andreevna Obushenkova in Management. Akash Parekh in Finance and a Bachelor of Commerce. Vladislav Vladimirovic Paschenko in Marketing and a Bachelor of Commerce. Hemal Patel in Accounting. Priyanka Patel in Accounting. Kate Elizabeth Quigg in Finance and a Bachelor of Commerce. Jonathan Caleb Ridler in International Business. Saskia Lockett Rusko in International Business and a Bachelor of Commerce. Grishma Shah in Marketing and a Bachelor of Commerce. Nicholas Peter Stenner in Economics and a Bachelor of Commerce, Bachelor of Science, Conjoint. Lena Su, Commercial Law. Nazneen Faroz Sukia in Marketing and a Bachelor of Commerce and a Graduate Diploma in Commerce. University Graduate Scholar Si Wen Wong in Accounting and a Bachelor of Commerce. Shui Lin Wong in Accounting. Joshua Meng On Wong in Accounting. Tracy Yuan Ting Wong in Information Systems. Joshua Jake Woodhead, Economics. Catherine Ying En Yung in accounting. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with Second Class Honours First Division, Jessica Yon Lee in marketing. Ku Lo in commercial law. Aidan John Mills in commercial law. Jaren Naidu in management. Jeffrey Michael Phillips, management. Jonathan Chian Min Su, management. Lindsley To Pei Shin in economics and a Bachelor of Commerce. Minan Vo, economics. Zikai Zhao in economics and a Bachelor of Commerce. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with Second Class Honours Second Division, Jasmine Lal, commercial law. Shane Rima Lal, commercial law. Joanna June O'Connor, commercial law and a Bachelor of Commerce. Annette Suk Kwan Wong, commercial law. To the degree of property honours with first class honours, Raywin Leslie Hills. To the degree of Bachelor of Property Honours with Second Class Honours First Division, Pavan Sharma. To the degree of Bachelor of Property Honours with Second Class Honours Second Division, Rachel Ann Oswald. To the degree of Master of Property with Second Class Honours First Division, Shani Fu. To the degree of Master of Taxation Studies with First Class Honours, Marion Ruth Francis. To the degree of Master of Taxation Studies with Second Class Honours First Division, Bradley Rees Thomas Bowman, and a Bachelor of Commerce Honours with Second Class Honours First Division in Commercial Law, and a Bachelor of Commerce Bachelor of Property conjoint. Annalise Vosloo. To the degree of Master of Taxation Studies with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Linda Jeanette Jafferick. To the degree of Master of Taxation Studies, Rabina Wati Chandra.
I now call upon the Vice-Chancellor to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting to you the doctoral graduands. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, James Alexander Latournelle in Management. Jamie investigated whether data collected through the New Zealand Defence Force's Personnel Attitude Survey could be used successfully to model intention to stay and actual voluntary exit of military personnel. His research has been applied to improve decision making in the Defence Force's human resource planning. Jamie. Yuri, CEO in marketing. Yuri conceptualised and explored the meanings that consumers ascribe to luxury brands. He developed a hermeneutic model of brand meaning and applied this model to gain a behavioural understanding of the consumption of luxury brands. The findings advance a new theory that extends our understanding of the consumption of luxury brands in contemporary markets. Henry Xiang Shi in management. Henry investigated both the family side of businesses and the business side of families by focusing on the nuanced relationship between the firm's value orientations and entrepreneurial processes. His work has contributed to the evolution of family business and entrepreneurship research. Ranjan Vaidya in Information Systems, University Doctoral Scholar. Ranjan investigated the major challenges to creating successful agricultural marketing information systems in developing countries. He identified trust and resignation as major challenges and suggested the solutions for building trust. Ranjan. And in absentia, all those other persons named in the Book of Convocation qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma in the Faculty of Business and Economics.
We're nearing the end of this graduation ceremony. So on behalf of the university, I invite all of today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. And while you are standing, this would be a great opportunity for the graduates to show their appreciation of their families and supporters and the staff of the university who have helped them as they achieved their qualifications. Thank you. This concludes this meeting of Council and Convocation of the University for the conferment of degrees and the award of diplomas. I now invite you all to sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Māori, then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of your programme.